Hello there. Welcome to the Moment of Grace. Today, I want to admonish you. If you are blessed, then add value. Truth of the matter is this. If you are born again, you are blessed already. Ephesians chapter 1 verse 3 says, blessed be God who has blessed us with all spiritual blessing already in Christ Jesus. So you are blessed. Therefore, add value. I want to read to you from the book of Philemon and verses 10 and 11. I beseech you for my son Onesimus, whom I have begotten in my bonds. That means he got that guy born again in prison. That guy was in prison and Paul was in prison with him, and Paul preached to that guy and that guy got born again and that guy is now a free man. Verse 11, which in time past was to you unprofitable, but now profitable to you and to me. Being a Christian is not just for our selfish hand of being blessed and going to heaven. Not at all. We are God's answer to the darkness on the earth. We are God's source to preserve the world. Walking in blessing on earth and making it to heaven cannot be divorced from how you live your life while you are on earth here in Christ Jesus. So Onesimus was a runaway bad boy. He was a bad boy that was in prison, and in prison he met Christ and came out of prison. And on being born again, he turned another leaf. A believer must be a value-adding person in every way. And I want to show you a few ways you should add value. Number one, add value to your biological family. The biological family or your adoptive family where you were raised, where you grew up, you must be part of that family. A believer, a born-again Christian, mustn't be part of family enmity, sibling rivalry. That mustn't be the, you mustn't be the concern for everybody in the family. You are the one everybody is concerned about, that you might snap, that something might go wrong. You mustn't be the one that when they are doing family meeting, everything is going well until you come and everything will be scattered. You mustn't be the one. I've seen born again Christians who don't talk to their family member. They don't talk to their sister. They don't talk to their brother. They are very difficult. I say, my God. If you have God, you will understand that being unprofitable should be part of what you will let go, having been born again. And charity begins at home. Number two, you must be profitable to the community, from neighborhood to school to work to where you're working. A believer in Christ must be a value-adding person. You mustn't be difficult to work with. You see, it's sad when believers are the most difficult people to work with in the office. A believer mustn't be the person who is coming late all the time and they are writing time sheet and is changing time and is such a difficult person that won't deliver his own job or our own job on time. And when they talk, you say, my God will fight for me. No, God doesn't fight such silly fight. Wake up. You must work on your value-adding personality. It's in you already. You just need to work on it. You can't be that person who hide your character flaw under the guise of being principled. You know, when people are difficult, very difficult people to work with in church, difficult at work, difficult at to say, I'm just principled. You're not principled, you're just difficult. You are not having value. When you are somewhere, things must work better. It's not when you are there that things should start scattering. You know, some people, when they show up, people start fighting. When they show up, places start scattering. People who have been friends before, who have been slapping each other, high five before, they start fighting. That's not the way to live Christian life. Christian life is a value-adding life. When you show up, people who have been enemy before should become friends. Onesimus was in prison, a non-profitable person before he got born again, but the Bible says now he's profitable. Christ was principled, and yet he had family and friends. You remember they invited him to wedding. So don't hide character flaw under being principled. Number three, you need to know that the blessed also had value to humanity. Tribal, racial, social, political difference will not turn a believer to a wicked person. You know, in some part of the world, they still stone people and burn people. And my question always is, are born again Christian in that place where they are burning people, where they are stoning people, and a born again Christian too does that and he goes to church on Sunday? No, you're not born again. You're not yet a child of God. You are still a child of the devil. A Christian adds value to humanity, not takes value from humanity. Listen to me. A Christian is not that person who they will put in government office and we steal the money that is meant for everybody. You steal the money in Ministry of Education. You steal money in Ministry of Health. You steal money in the Ministry of Housing. So people who are supposed to be educated are not educated. People who are supposed to be given health service are not given health service. People who are supposed to be given house are not given house. And yet you have money to do all kind of things. It makes no difference how much tithe you pay on such money. The curse of the Lord is in your house. You need to repent. A Christian is a value-adding person. The blessed have value to humanity. They don't mind the political difference, the racial difference. A Christian shouldn't be tribalistic, shouldn't be racial. I've seen a lot of Christians, and this has a lot to do with the so-called evangelical in America. Many of them are still so racist. Many of them are still so prejudiced. And many of them, I don't care how much television program you are doing. When you are not adding value to humanity, Christianity in your hand is still not light of the world, is still not salt of the earth. A blessed person can't afford to be heartless, to be wicked, to be selfish, to be inconsiderate. You are the salt of the earth, not the gallstone. You shouldn't be adding the bitterness. You should be adding sweetness. You should be preserving. And that is why God sent me to you today. That being blessed means value has been put in your hand for you to hurt to the world. And I pray that you will not fail Christ. I pray that you will not fail yourself. I pray that you will not fail your family. I pray that you will not fail the society. I pray that you will not fail the community. In the mighty name of Jesus, I pray that the work of your hand will prosper and that Jesus will take glory in all that you do. In Jesus' mighty name. I also pray for sickness in someone's body right now. God sent me to pray for the sick and to see healing done in their body. So therefore, I curse that sickness. If you put hand on that place, I command that sickness to go. The swelling disappear. The tumor go. The pain vanish. Whatsoever you couldn't do before, I release life of God there now. Start doing it in the name of Jesus. For Christ himself took your infirmity and bore your grief. Chastisement of your peace was on him. By his stripes you had been healed. Be healed right now in Jesus' mighty name. I want you to go on Amazon, my friend, and check our new book, Noah Template of Enterprise Success. It will do you a lot of good.